वेलकम टू टेक्निया टीवी। आई डॉक्टर सचिन सबरवाल, फैकल्टी एमबीए ऑफ टेक्निया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एडवांस स्टडीज। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन मोनोपोलिस्टिक कंपटीशन। मोनोपोलिस्टिक कंपटीशन इज अ सिचुएशन इन विच द मार्केट बेसिकली इज अ कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट बट हैज सम एलिमेंट्स ऑफ अ मोनोपोली। इन दिस फॉर्म ऑफ मार्केट देयर आर मैनी फर्म्स to that sell closely differentiated products. That means the products that look alike but have certain differences in terms of shape, size, color, quantity, fragrance, etc. The examples of this kind of market are mobiles, cosmetics, detergents, toothpastes, and any other FMCG products. The features of this market are, first, large number of buyers and sellers. In this form of market, while the buyers are as large as it is under perfect competition or monopoly, the number of sellers is not as large as the perfect competition. Therefore, each firm has the ability to alter or influence the price of the product it sells to some extent. That is, the firm has some ability to change the price. That is, if the demand is high, the firm can charge a higher price than its competitor, or if the demand is less, then it can charge a lesser price than its competitors. Then product differentiation. Second feature is product differentiation. Under monopolistic competition, products are differential or differentiated. That is, this means that the product is same but have certain distinguishing factor. That is, the brands sold by the firms differ in terms of packaging, size, color, features, etc. For example, soaps that you use in your daily needs, toothpaste, mobile instruments, etc. The importance of product differentiation is that it creates an image in the minds of the people that the product sold by one seller is different from that of the other. Products are very similar to each other but not identical or homogeneous. This allows substitution of the product of one firm with that of another. Due to a large number of substitutes being available, demand for a firm's product is relatively elastic. Third feature is selling cost or promotion cost. As the products are close substitutes of each other, they are needed to be differentiated in the firms that incurring selling cost in making advertisements, sales promotion, warranties, customer services, packaging, colors, and brand creation. Fourth point is free entry and exit of firms. Like perfect competition, free entry and exit of firms is possible under this market since there are no barriers of entry and exit. That is, any firm that is considering this market as a profitable one can enter into the market, and the firms that are considering it as a loss making market, then they can easily exit. The firms operating under monopolistic competition in the long run can earn normal profits due to this factor. That is, if the firms are earning losses, then some of the firms that cannot bear the losses for a long run can leave the industry. And the firms, if the firms are getting excess profits, or that is known as abnormal profits, then the new firms can get attracted towards the market and can join the industry. Thereby, the normal profits is retained. Next topic is shape of AR and MR curves under monopoly. Under monopolistic competition, like monopoly, both the AR and MR curves are downward sloping. A downward sloping demand curve or AR curve implies that in order to sell more, the firm has to reduce the price. That is, it can only sell more output by reducing the price. So the shape of AR curve, like the demand curve, normal demand curve, it is downward sloping. However, the AR and MR curves are flatter under monopolistic competition in comparison to monopoly, because in monopoly they have very less or no choice. But in monopolistic competition, they have a wider choice that is creating more elasticity in the market, that the consumer have choice, and if the price is higher by one seller, then it can easily shift to another with equal ease. As you can see in the diagram, that AR curve and MR curve are downward sloping, and MR curve will lie underneath AR curve. In conclusion, we can say that a monopolistic market is the market that we witness in our day-to-day life, that is the market which is around us. What we carry in our pockets is the part of the monopolistic competition. For example, a mobile phone in our pocket, a pen in our hand, a notebook that we require in our college and other stationary requirements, and all the things are of part of monopolistic competition. That is, we are getting more and more substitutes by the entry of new firms, and we use this type of products in our daily life. I hope that the lecture is quite understandable. For watching more videos like this, subscribe Technia TV.